Direct from Las Vegas, the Auto Channel presents press pass coverage at the 2008 Alternative Fuels and Vehicles National Conference and Expo.
Okay, and thanks again to Jeff, Greg, and Gerald, and we're going to switch out. If you've joined us just recently, again, this is the light duty segment. We've got six presentations. We're going to bring them up as quickly as we can, and then, of course, move on to the Q&A right afterwards, followed by a break, and then we'll bring up the heavy and medium duty vehicles. So, without further ado, I'm just going to switch it up, and what I'll do is I'll go ahead and introduce you each before you talk. So I'll begin with you, Mike. Mike McGarry, if you haven't, well, it's not obvious. If you see, all of these names, of course, are in our agenda guide here, but he's got amongst the longest titles that I've ever seen. He's the Marketing Manager, Alternative Fuels Fleet and Commercial Operations, Vehicle Sales, Service and Marketing, General Motors Corporation. So on the three cards that he gives you that lists all of that, he was the Marketing Manager for Alternative Vehicle Fuel Vehicles and primary responsibility supporting the sales and marketing efforts for GM's current flex fuel and hybrid operations and for their fleet and commercial customers. He also manages the Green Team for GM, a group that encourages cross-functional communication on green activities within the GM marketing and field sales, public policy, and communication organizations. Prior to joining the fleet and commercial in 2006, he had various assignments in field and national sales, service, and marketing organizations. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike McGarry.
Thank you, Tom. Okay. Again, welcome. Thanks for being here this afternoon. Get into the presentation mode. It's going to be a challenge to talk about everything that GM is doing in a short amount of time, but we'll hit the highlights. And tomorrow morning, Larry Burns, our Vice President of Research and Development and Strategic Planning, is one of the keynote speakers. So he'll fill in a lot of the missing pieces and add to what we talk about here today. This is our advanced propulsion technology strategy. Along the left-hand side, you know, what we're trying to do is to improve fuel economy and emissions while displacing petroleum. Along the bottom is the different fuels and energies, petroleum, biofuels, electricity, hydrogen, and so on. And you know, in the lower left-hand corner, we're starting off with internal combustion engine and transmission improvements. We'll talk about each of these things here just in a minute, and then moving up the scale to hybrid electric vehicles, including hybrids, battery electric vehicles on what we call our E-Flex platform, and hydrogen fuel cells. What we've done is basically worked with our marketing people to develop. Okay, thank you. We've worked with our marketing people to come up with icons for all these different strategies, and moving from left to right, we're going from gas-friendly to gas-free. Again, as some of the other gentlemen spoke about, we're doing a lot of things with the traditional internal combustion engines, from direct fuel injection, variable valve timing, cylinder deactivation, turbocharging, six-speed transmissions. We'll be getting into seven-speed, eight-speed transmissions as well, and also working with cleaner and more powerful diesel engines. This is a list. We have the most vehicles in 2008 that get over 30 miles to the gallon on the highway, and this is a list of those vehicles. You can see that some of them are hybrids, and some of them are a couple small utility vehicles there. Again, a wide range of vehicles if you're looking for fuel economy improvement. Also, our pickup trucks have the best fuel economy in the lineup of any vehicles currently sold in America. That includes the hybrid 2 mode, which will be coming out late this fall, and we'll talk about that here shortly. Again, obviously, General Motors has been involved with the promotion of ethanol and ethanol-related vehicles, and the reason for that is that ethanol offers the best near-term solution for reducing dependency on petroleum. This slide shows that the different varieties of ethanol, reduce greenhouse gas emissions, and obviously cellulosic ethanol, which we're all working towards, would reduce CO2 by 70 to 86%. We'll talk a little bit more about that in a minute. If we continue to develop ethanol and the infrastructure that's required, we feel that we can reduce oil demand by as much as 30%, again across the industry by 2030. We've recently formed two partnerships, one with Coscata and one with Mascoma. Coscata, based outside of Chicago, is working on cellulosic technology. I've got to go to my my note here. They're developing a thermochemical process that will make ethanol from non-grain sources. And then Mascoma in New Hampshire is developing single-step biochemical conversions of non-grain biomass into alt fuels. And again, Coscata and Mascoma are working on producing ethanol for less than $1 a gallon and using non-food-based products. I think Mr. Burns will speak more about that tomorrow. And again, just from a global perspective, GM is the world leader in providing choice through flex fuel. In the United States, we call it flex fuel technology. In Brazil, we call it flex power. And about 90% of the vehicles that we sell in Brazil are ethanol capable, up to E100. And then Saab also has two of the most popular models in Europe. Their 9.3 and their 9.5 are also E85 capable. This is the list of 2009 flex fuel vehicles. The ones highlighted in yellow are new for 2009. And again, I think these presentations are available on the website after the conference, and we also have a lot of literature in our booth, which will give you a complete listing of all of our vehicles and the ones that are both E85 capable and hybrid capable. Again, we've added some vehicles in some different segments, the Malibu and the G6, and also the Buick Lucerne, and Escalade and Denali XL. As far as B20, we have a special equipment option that's available on Silverado Sierra 1-ton and 3/4-ton heavy-duty trucks. This year we've added 3/4-ton availability. We also have it on the Express and the Savannah cutaway vans. All of our 6.6-liter Duramax diesels are B5 approved. And again, we can talk to you more about B20 and biodiesel if you want to stop by our booth. Now, this is a list of GM hybrids that we'll have, along with the associated miles per gallon where we have them. And then we'll just run through, again, what we have. The Chevy Malibu and the Saturn Aura are the what we call the GM hybrid system. They're the most affordable midsize hybrid sedans. They also currently have a $1,200 tax credit available for anybody that purchases them, which will offset the additional cost for the hybrid, which is only about $2,200 right now. Fuel economy 24 city, 32 highway. All of our hybrids have an 8-year, 100,000-mile warranty on the hybrid components, which includes the battery. The Saturn View, there's actually two hybrids available in the Saturn View. Currently, we have the GM hybrid system, which again makes it the lowest priced sport utility hybrid on the market. And late this fall, we'll be coming with a two-mode hybrid. The two-mode process, if you're not familiar with it, and there's a lot of information again on our websites which explains it, it's actually two electric motors inside the transmission, and that will allow you to improve your fuel economy both in the city and on the highway. And again, we've got some two-mode Tahoes and Yukons available in our ride and drive, and you really have to drive this vehicle. It's very unique. It will run on full electric power up to 30 miles an hour. Again, in 2009, later this year, we'll have the Silverado Sierra Hybrid. It will get 25% improved fuel economy, 40% better in the city. We don't have actual ratings on it yet, but we expect it to be far beyond the competition in the segment. Again, we're not sacrificing any capability. It still has a 6,100 pound towing capability. Again, all electric up to 30 miles an hour. and it is part of the best lineup in the industry. Again, new for 2009, we have the first hybrid in a large luxury SUV. It will deliver over a 50% improvement in the city. Again, we're expecting about 35 to 40 improvement on the highway. It will be available this summer in both two-wheel and four-wheel drive configurations. And again, a vehicle we talked about last year and is currently in dealership showrooms is the Tahoe Hybrid, two-mode hybrid, along with the GMC Yukon two-mode hybrid. It was named Green Car of the Year and won a host of other awards here this year. It also has a 50% overall improvement in fuel economy. The two-wheel drive will achieve 22 in the city and 21 on the highway. We are working on the Saturn View plug-in, which will also have a more advanced battery. We're working on lithium-ion battery technology. It will be a plug-in, and it will also have the two-mode technology. Also, we expect that it will double the fuel efficiency of any non-hybrid SUV on the market. Moving through a little bit further in the future, we are working on extended range electric vehicles. Last year we talked a lot about the Volt, and since then we've introduced the Opel Flexstream in Europe and also the Cadillac Provoke, which again Mr. Burns will talk a little bit more about tomorrow. These are gasoline extended range electric vehicles with lithium ion battery technology. They will be charged by plug-in overnight or at any time, and we're working on configurations that are both fuel cell capable or internal combustion engine that will be used to charge the battery. Again, we're targeting a 40-mile EV driving range, electric-only driving range, and then the engine or the fuel cell will power the vehicle beyond the 40-mile capability. Again, we anticipate a driving range of several hundred miles without refueling, but the nice thing about the extended range vehicle is you could drive it from coast to coast, whereas if you had a purely electric vehicle, you'd have to be stopping to recharge batteries. So the internal combustion engine of the fuel cell vehicle will charge the batteries, you know, while you're driving or as necessary. Again, fuel economy is a little difficult to calculate with these types of vehicles, but one of the calculations that you could use gives you a composite fuel economy of about 150 miles to the gallon. And again, electricity is the lower cost alternative to petroleum and can be produced in a wide variety of sources, again, which Larry Burns will discuss tomorrow. Very quickly about hydrogen fuel cells. Obviously, the reason why we're looking at hydrogen fuel cells is for overall sustainability. Zero petroleum, zero greenhouse gas emissions, and zero tailpipe emissions. And you've probably heard about Project Driveway. It's the largest fuel cell test fleet. We have 100 fuel cell vehicles that will be part of this test fleet over the next 3 years. We've already had over 1,500 people that have tested these vehicles. And we'll actually have two of these vehicles in the ride and drive that you can drive tomorrow. I believe it's on Tuesday. There's about 50,000 people that have gone to Chevy.com and have signed up to be part of this fuel cell test. If you're in the LA, Washington DC, or New York City area, you could sign up to be part of the Project Driveway fuel cell test. And again, why we're doing it and what we expect to learn. We want to understand driver reactions to the vehicle, the ride handling performance, refueling, speed, availability, access, and just the overall experience. And we've already got about 27 vehicles out in the hands of Walt Disney Corporation in California and also in the New York area. And also Ben and Jackie Lee of Burbank, California were our first drivers. And they've actually already spent 3 months in their vehicle and have provided some very valuable feedback. Again, we're going to use these learnings to guide future development of fuel cells. We've learned a lot about marketing these vehicles, outreach efforts, and obviously a lot about infrastructure development, again, which we'll talk about more tomorrow. This is the Cadillac Provoke fuel cell concept, again, just to give you an idea of where we're going and how serious we are about fuel cell technology. This vehicle has the fifth generation fuel cell and a lithium ion battery, and will have a 300 mile range on a single fill of hydrogen. I just had to show this slide because I think it's so cool with the solar panel that that powers the onboard accessories. And with that, again, our advanced propulsion technology, we're going to reduce fuel consumption, greenhouse gases. It'll be sustainable through energy diversity, displace petroleum. We want to alleviate the issue of demand outgrowing the limited supply, and we want to reduce our dependence on a supply that's subject to uncontrollable risks. Again, we'll have folks in our display and quite a few vehicles in the ride and drive. Thank you for your time.
For more Press Pass coverage of all major automotive events, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.